Shalom, good evening. We will continue with I shall be who I shall be, Be'ezrat Hashem, with God's help. One of the things we've been talking a lot lately, it's the gematria of 1020. What is a four river, four time Nahar? And we parallel the four river to four concepts. What is Avraham plus Yitzhak plus Yaakov plus Esav? That equals this number, and we parallel this to Cohen, Levi, Israel, Mashiach. It's like the four reel of the chariot.
Wheels
of the chariot. Arba'at galgalei ha-merkava, the way we call it in Kabbalah. The four direction of the earth, the south, the north,
cardinal directions.
Yes, it's parallel to these four concepts. That is it's like the most principal four from all the seven.
The main
from the seven midot, from the seven attributes of the heart. We take four of them that represent the four animals, the four wheels, etc.
The most important ones, relevant ones.
All right, so all the book of Revelation, it was built on these four concepts. And we did the gematria of Avraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov with Vav, plus Esav, equal Cohen, Levi, Israel, Mashiach, what it's completely parallel four concepts. What equal four time river. And this number equal the name I shall be if I write a big Aleph. Right? A big Aleph like 1,000. And the other three letter equal 20. Ehe, right? I don't write as one word because if the intention is the name of God, it's one of the name of God that, so it's a name that we don't raise. So if
you don't write,
we can't write. We don't raise. Raise limchok.
Erase.
Erase. We don't erase.
We don't delete it.
We don't delete. In a computer we can delete, but not on something like this, right?
Paper, so on a board.
If I mean that I shall be, if what I talk about is just I shall be, you will be, they will be, it's not a holy name. But if I talk about the name of God, I shall be, who I shall be, so it's a name that we don't raise. It's a holy name that represent the mother in Kabbalah, the Bina. I'm not yet. I will be born. I will be realized. All right, so it's a name that represents the future. So if I write this name that usually equal 21 with a big Aleph as 1,000, because the number Aleph, what it means 1,000, we write it like the letter Aleph, the same letter, all right? So the one become 1,000. So very simple, this name equals this four river, something we've been talking about many times. Another thing that equals this number is Ashgacha Pratit. How you translate Ashgacha Pratit?
Private providence.
Ashgacha Pratit, and this number equal 10 times 102, what is 10 times emuna? 10 times faith. We have here 10 letters. Ashgacha pratit, this means the average value of each letter of Ashgacha pratit. How you say Ashgacha pratit?
Private providence.
Divine providence, etc. So, the average value of each letter is faith, believe, emuna. Okay, so emuna. Have to do with mother, M. Start with M. Have to do with emuna. Really, emet, it's like a true, it's a concept of, it's like the same root, emet, true. Should be, it's like the masculine of emuna, emet. Should be amenet, but the nun, it's a letter that fell down. Right, so emet, true, is like this. But start with M as well.
So they are related.
Together, emuna plus emet equal I shall be who I shall be. 543. And emet, what is emet? Emet is 441. Emuna is 102. Together is 543. What is the reverse? Number of Moses, like we said. Moshe equal 345. I shall be who I shall be is 543. So we can see here that the main thing is the symmetry that has to do with this name.
It's very interesting, very relevant. Emet.
Emet.
So you need emuna in order to get to the emet. You need faith in order to reach the truth. And truth. And there's another faith for the next level of emet, so it's kind of a ladder, you're just going up and up and up.
Yeah, you go from emuna is like above consciousness, it become realized as emet. Emet, it means realization too. Le'amet, it's like to realize a promise, sira of yesod, call emet, because it has to do with realization of the promise. All right, so when something that it was just a faith become realize, it's like something that was in a state of night. It is written, Emunatcha b'leilot, your faith in the night. When it become
manifested
as a day, so in the day we say after Shema, Emet. In the night we say, in the end of Shema, Emuna. Right? So it's like night and day. Together is I shall be who I shall be. Emet 441 is 21 square. So we can say that one of the meaning of I shall be who I shall be is I shall be time I shall be.
Which is Emet.
What is Emet?
Wow.
Alright, so I shall be who I shall be is a realization of the two namekye. In the moment we have a name, a free word in symmetry, we have one word, another word in the middle, and another word from the other side, immediately you receive association of symmetry. All right, so we know that you have a mother from one side, another mother from another side, and in the middle you have the father, the point
what
of virginity.
Which are the two mothers in this case? What do you say, mother from one side and the other side? How can you?
We've been talking all the time you have all this thing in the two sides. This is the middle point, and you have all this thing in the two sides.
You mean the two aleph?
The
like
two
that,
aleph,
exactly, the two
exactly, the two aleph. Okay. The two aleph. So you have one and the two mothers, it's like the two wings. You understand what I say? We talk about the flying snake. Okay? We talk about the flying snake. So this two is I shall be that have to do came after the wisdom. It's like the mother in this reality. And it's like another I shall be that is in godliness. But what is the crown above the wisdom? Now we saw always that the crown have to do with the past. Adam Kadmon, Kadum. Please translate Adam Kadmon.
The primordial man.
All right, so Atik Yomin, ancient of the day, etc.
Ancient of
the day. All right, so the crown have to do with the past. So how come we have... How come the two sides can be future? How can we realize we do a connection between the future in one side and the past in the other side?
Because in spirituality it is above time and space. So we come from Aleph, we are in Bet, and we go back to Gimel.
It's the
so Aleph and Gimel are basically the same from God's
still,
point
we see that the crown represents the past.
Yes.
Kadmon. It is a says that...
So they meet in a circle somehow, the whole reality.
But what make, if I want to make connection between the past and the future, what I need?
You need the present.
I need the present, but what I have in the present, what it's now?
You have the cross? I don't know.
I need a snake.
A snake?
A snake is a letter Vav. Now Vav...
The letter of connection.
Vav is a letter of connection when this came in the name of God between the two Hey.
Yud Kei Vav Kei.
It's like we say, from the world to the world. Min Ha'olam Ad Ha'olam. It's like four words parallel to Yud Kei Vav Kei.
Four worlds.
From the world...
World.
Of Olam Abba, world who came, to this
where
world.
To
this world, okay. Olam Hazeh. So it's Hey and Hey, and it's a Vav of connection. Uh-huh. This is a Vav of connection.
But so the bottom Vav is like a Malkut, this world, and Hey above is the world to come?
Yes, the two Hey is a word, is a concept of word.
Of mother
it's
mother.
Always a word.
World.
It is a physical world and it is a more spiritual world.
World.
Okay, so this is the two Hey. Uh-huh. It is a darkness that is a lot of light, and it is darkness that is missing of light.
Lack of
this light. Is darkness, and this is darkness. Darkness is female,
yeah.
And is faith.
Faith.
It is a stage of so much light that I don't see anything, that is a mother, and it is a stage that is no light, so it's darkness again. It seems to be the same.
And
right?
How is Vav in connection to those
so
two?
So this is Vav of this world. Called Vav of connection. Now it is another Vav. We call it Vav Ha'ipuch.
Ipuch is a reversal.
If
upside down. Basically.
If I have a verb in past and I add to it a Vav, this becomes future. Alachta. You went, right?
Okay.
Alachta. It's in the past. Now, if I put a va, vehalachta, it's in the future. And you will go.
In Hebrew, it's like telech.
Yeah, I talk about biblical language.
Ah, biblical language is a vav.
Vatelech.
Talk about the future.
Vatelech. Is in the future. Vatelech Rivka or Vatelech Vayelech Avraham, it means in the past. In the moment I add a vav, the future becomes the past and the past becomes the future. So this is the secret of the snake in the middle that make connection between the two mother, the two aleph.
So they are upside down, one in relative to the other. They are upside down.
So the vav brings the past to the future,
okay,
and bring the future to the past and make a connection and make a unity, but in a special way that he reverses the time. This is a snake that is in the middle, the nachash. Nachash is called Mashiach. This is in the middle, as nachash is a sav as well. Okay, so in the middle of these two aleph, you have, like we said, we have a vav, we have a snake. It's like Asher, Ezekiel, as in the middle is Asher. Okay, so this Asher in the middle is connected to the concept of the snake. Is a tzaddik. The letter tzaddik that have to do with the... Now we are in the month of Asher, the month of Shvat. The letter is tzaddik. So tzaddik is the righteous man that make connection. But it is a regular connection. It's like a vector of energy from here, to make a connection between me and you is a distance. So we need somebody that makes the connection. And it is another kind of connection that reverses the time. It's not only connection. By doing this connection, it reverses the time. So then it makes connection between what was and what will be. The two ekies. So together is true. 21 square, 21 times 21. Okay?
It's like a matrix of the past and the future. Seems perhaps like a matrix of the like a graph of the past and the future, and I don't know.
All right, so it's a lot of things. It's a nice thing to meditate about this. You know, people ask many times how Jesus, when exactly was the Last Supper? There's a big question about this. When was the Last Supper of Jesus? If it was a Pesach, it looked like it was a Pesach, but from the other side he sent the guy to bring stuff, to buy stuff. So they are not in Pesach. Out they are not in Pesach. But how they can be in Pesach when they do this meal, if it is not yet Pesach? So somehow maybe they travel in time. You make this connection. This kind of connection, all right? How you did it?
But it can be another
answer to this problem that he celebrated Pesach even he was not yet Pesach. You know, he took all his disciple, you know, the old hand, and he took them, close the eyes. All right, now we are in Pesach. Okay, so we can imagine all kind of traveling in time that has to do with this name and with this vav that in the middle.